As you see there, FCHAMP extremely defensive, master of the space control, while HAITANI, calm and collective, and does pretty well at reading his opponents.
I mean, look, as a DHALSIM player, defensive and space control are... That's your MO. That's what it's what you got to be good at.
Inherently, you should be, right? If you're going to be playing a character like DHALSIM, who's a little fragile.
Yeah, but look, I expect this first round, or first few rounds, to really tell the tale of this matchup, unless there's some kind of error, you know, in the way this will go. But yeah, it's really going to be Champ's going to hit HAITANI with about 11 standing medium kicks. Then he'll get V-Trigger, and the match will be over. That's about what'll happen. That's the summary of it, right? If you don't want to go and pay tickets to see the movie, I'll give you guys the short version.
The TLDR,
yeah. Okay, this is big. Sweep already. And sweep is a good choice against DHALSIM with pretty much any character. As you know, DHALSIM's punish on a sweep is not huge. He doesn't get a lot. Those blocks are great for HAITANI as his V-Gauge fills up really quickly. You can see Trigger's almost on deck already for HAITANI.
Nice. Gonna neutralize that pressure altogether. HAITANI just jumping out of there.
Alright, so now V-Trigger is available for HAITANI. He can pop off of a button. Or just in neutral if he wants. You see the mobility from FCHAMP? This is not something that he usually does a lot of. He's not moving around like crazy. It's really because he's forced to in this matchup. Oh, how many?
Oh my goodness!
How many? He did not want to block. The snipe? Okay.
The uppercut?
He gets the loose. Yeah, this might be
reset.
Over.
Reset?
This might be over. But he guessed right. Good block low. Teleport in place. Oh, he got him!
Oh, we got the double dash
uppercut. One more guess. It's a guess.
And he got it. HAITANI. Wow.
Look, how many stand medium kicks did he hit him with? Maybe not 11.
It was like three.
But quite a few. And this is how this matchup goes. It's Champ playing the zoning game, doing well to keep HAITANI out, and then suddenly that happens. Big jump. And you see he's maximizing the V-Gauge in this matchup. That's the priority for HAITANI. That's what it has to be. No V-Reversal was available. Wow, that jab hit.
Oh, and the dive kick was on point, stuffing that cross-medium punch.
Oh, he's
and that's
stunned
it.
Just like that, yeah.
Ooh, HAITANI.
Look, that's how this matchup's going to go. And if you're Filipino champ, you know that. Like, right, he obviously has talked a little bit about how this matchup's been going. But, yeah, that's kind of what we expect.
Really tough scenario for FCHAMP. Still trying to figure out a way to stop that pressure that his height's on. It's so so dangerous as anything. His jumping timings were good. Got the dive kicks going. Trying to mix it up. FCHAMP is just still got a lot to work with, though.
Yeah, I mean, the zoning was going okay, especially in the first round. Second round, not so much. But yeah, you see the dash from HAITANI. He's risking the sweeps. And you could totally do that if you are, you know, NECALLI. Oh, he's in there.
Not so fast.
The Gale again. Same series even for last time. Big combo, but it wasn't turned into a knockdown, so Filipino champ stays alive. What an anti-air. Drill, and he teleports away, expecting maybe uppercut. And you see the fear in Filipino champ's play. He's playing so slow, so much movement. He really does not want to get locked down by this character. Slide in is good. And Filipino champ finds the hit. HAITANI still has the V-Trigger to pop, but hasn't yet. Wow, trade. Could have been trade, but no.
Still a dangerous situation. HAITANI going into the V-Trigger now.
Oh, wow, sweep. Yeah, it's punished.
Nice air to air.
Uh-oh, this is big. Yeah, you see the space he gets off of that. Crush.
Man.
He's one guess. One guess. Got him,
oh,
and that is
goodness.
That. Yeah, even at that range, the slide was just unsafe, and HAITANI gets the punish. Look at how quickly, right? He was down to 10%. Fights his way across the stage. You see the sweeps. Yeah, again, HAITANI's just fishing with it because when they hit, look at this.
HAITANI backing off just a little bit. There's the V-Reversal. Champ just trying to regain his composure, trying to get that spacing back.
Couldn't get through. That float is nice. It's good to get above everything. Finally, he teleports in and it doesn't work.
Got the slide, couldn't get much off of that though.
Another stomp. And you can see him just moving in.
HAITANI just waiting like a shark.
Yeah, he's just hanging out at that range. Knows what to look for from Filipino Jam. And there's the escape. Yeah, he used that EX to get past HAITANI. But now V-Trigger's available for HAITANI, you gotta know. That's an issue.
And that's the activation, that's gonna be dead. It, yeah.
Yeah, just like that, right? It's that one little pop on the V trigger.
Yeah, so FCHAMP's strategy majority of the time is to try to stay away, right? He's going to use all the limbs possible just to kind of keep HAITANI away. But again, once he has V-Trigger, it's been the problem. As soon as that activation goes off, tons of damage coming his way, potentially. It's just such a tough time for Filipino champ.
Yeah, this is a hard fight. I mean, you can just see it. HAITANI makes the reads on the way in, and that's what matters. All right, it's character select.
Yeah, it's going to take some time to really think it out. I know he does have a pocket Nash.
Yeah, he has another character that he could go to, but, you know, it's whether he wants to switch away from DHALSIM, the character he knows best, right?
Really contemplating it, taking his time here. Alright, he's going back into DHALSIM. Good choice.
Still hasn't locked in. But it is.
Alright, so here we go. Filipino champ, HAITANI. HAITANI up 2-0.
Yeah, it was a quick 2-0-2, kind of a steamrolling.
So again, we're going to see if Filipino champ kind of steps it up here. I kind of want to see a little bit more active play in terms of the mix-ups and the teleporting instead of staying out of the range. No NTS there.
Yeah, the issue really is that, you know, he can't force these mix-ups. All right, finally, he's going to have offense here if he wants it. But yeah, you see him play patient. A little check after, just in case HAITANI would hit a button.
Nice.
You see those sweeps. So many sweeps from HAITANI. He's willing to just stick it out. Reversal.
Good call.
Oh, slapped him out of the air and got great damage from it.
FCHAMP a little bit more active up close, setting up the mix-up. No, gets the air to air instead.
And this is okay for him. You can see that the V-trigger from NECALLI came so late in the round. Oh, yeah, it worked, but he didn't believe.
Gotta believe. Gets the slap anyway. Instant air jab. There we go. A little bit more active. HAITANI still thinking it out.
Yeah, definitely a better round for Filipino champ, but it's whether he can keep this up, right?
Right.
Yeah, there's the uppercut.
HAITANI getting the uppercut in.
And that dive kick tough to anti-air. You gotta predict it.
Nice roundhouse. Ready for it. Good reactions.
Brings out roundhouse again. It's a little slow. Gale works. Oh man, gotta imagine that was uppercut. See those sweeps from HAITANI again. It's been a consistent button he likes in the mid range. Snipe two, man. Champ is playing this slow and steady. It's a really good pace for himself. And, you know, because he forced that V reversal, HAITANI is far from V trigger. Now he's a bit closer. That fierce definitely buffered into critical art.
Like that, FCHAMP is still playing nice and cool here. He's not going to take any risks right now.
Gotta be careful. V-trigger
right there.
Is still dangerous. NECALLI could get in there at any chance.
Ooh.
Pops. Yeah, he's just got to at this point. He doesn't have enough life to risk it anymore.
FCHAMP is still going to be content in the corner. Pops to go in.
Oh, he looked for the mix-up. Champ didn't buy it.
Great defense.
And he risks it. Gotta watch the throw, yeah. Tech. Slide under is good, and he's dead.
He got
just
it.
Like
HAITANI with the confirm. And you gotta think, right? FCHAMP didn't press any buttons on defense, but that command grab could have been coming one way or another.
I mean, dude.
Still.
He had 80% lead.
That's
80% lead, and then so quickly he just explodes off of one series.
Absurd. Double dash out the gate. HAITANI really just wants to get in DHALSIM's face.
Yeah, I mean, HAITANI is doing an excellent job to play to really maximize every scenario here versus DHALSIM. He's playing excellently.
Ooh,
one
more
for
stun. Nice. Get out of there. HAITANI stalking his prey, kind of closing the gap a little bit.
Yeah, and he has such a lead. You know, we've seen so far that he's brought a lot of games back, but this is such a deficit for Filipino champ. Another interrupt again. Look at this, man. HAITANI all over him. And you know, Filipino champ's gonna need something big here. He's gonna need a confirm and a critical art.
Yeah,
maybe
a little,
even a mix up from there.
A little reluctant to do so. He's just trying to get in there.
Anti-air is
nice
good,
anti-air.
But trade, yeah, not in DHALSIM's favor. He has such low life. What? He just dashed all the
dash
way up there. and got the throw. Man, what a choice from Haitani. And look, he played that excellently. In a match where you can afford to take risks, I think that he really didn't take a ton. The risks he took were so calculated. I like the sweeps that he was bringing out. I think that's a great option.